Hi friends, our topic is glycolysis. Glycolysis is also called Embren-Meyerhof pathway. It is an oxidative process. It takes place in cytosol of the cell. The meaning of glycolysis is breakdown of the sugars or carbohydrates. Here glyco means carbohydrate, lysis means splitting or breakdown. This oxidation takes place is mainly in responsible for the conversion of six carbon compound, which is a glucose or any other carbohydrate. Here glucose is converted into 2 pyruvate molecules. This is an oxidative process. Here glycolysis will takes place in the presence of oxygen or in the absence of oxygen. If glycolysis takes place in the presence of oxygen, means aerobic glycolysis. In the absence of glycolysis takes place, that type of glycolysis is called anaerobic glycolysis. Glycolysis contain mainly two phases, which is the first one is preparatory phase and second one is payoff phase. In preparatory phase, energy is invested or utilized, so it is called preparatory phase. Preparatory phase means we are preparing the glucose molecule to break down, so this is named as preparatory phase. Next, second phase is payoff phase. Here energy is producing which is invested in preparatory phase, so it is called payoff. The first step to fifth step, it is called preparatory phase, and sixth step to tenth step, it is called payoff phase. Here the series of reactions are given. Here glycolysis total takes place in 10 steps. The first 5 preparatory phases are here. Here we are taking the sugar or carbohydrate is glucose molecule. Glucose molecule is a 6 carbon compound, which is converted into glucose 6 phosphate. In first step, glucose 6 phosphate is also 6 carbon compound, but it is added with a phosphate group, so this step is called phosphorylation. Here the enzyme involved in this reaction is hexokinase. Requires magnesium ion for the proper function. This step is an exergonic process, because here free energy released is negative value, so it is an exothermic reaction. Next, second step is here glucose 6 phosphate is converted into fructose 6 phosphate. Glucose and fructose are both are isomers, so fructose is an isomer of glucose. So here this process is called isomerization. Here 6 phosphate is, glucose 6 phosphate is produced, means how the name is here, the structure of glucose 6 phosphate is here. This is a first carbon, this is second, this is third, this is fourth, this is fifth, this is sixth. In sixth place of the glucose we are adding phosphate group, so it is named as glucose 6 phosphate. In next step, second step, structure of the fructose 6 phosphate is here. Here everything is similar to glucose, because it is an isomer of glucose. The enzyme involved in this reaction is phosphoglucoisomerase, which is a endergonic process, because free energy released here is positive value. The first step is only unidirectional. It takes place from glucose to glucose 6 phosphate conversion. This glucose 6 phosphate is not again converted into glucose, so it is an unidirectional reaction. Here second step is bidirectional. Next, third step is here fructose 6 phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6 bisphosphate. This is also unidirectional reaction. Here first and third steps are unidirectional steps. Here the enzyme utilized here is phosphofructokinase, which also require magnesium ion. This is also phosphorylation reaction which uses ATP as energy. It is an exergonic process. Next, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Here fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is named because in see here structure in first carbon phosphate group is added. So first and sixth carbon, both the places we are adding phosphate group, so it is called fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Next fourth step, it is a cleavage type of reaction. In this process, mainly 6 carbon compound, which is fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, is converted into 2-3 carbon compounds, that is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphates. The enzyme involved in this cleavage reaction is aldolase, which also requires zinc metal ion for the proper function of aldolase. Next, glycerol, 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde is produced here. We require 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde phosphate for the glycolysis. But here, this 6 carbon compound is converted into 1 molecule of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and 1 molecule of dihydroxyacetone phosphate. These both are isomers. So 1 molecule of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is converted into dihydroxyacetone phosphate by isomerization reaction. For this reaction, we are using triose phosphate isomerase enzyme. This is also bidirectional enzyme. In preparatory phase, only first step and third step were unidirectional, which are regulating steps in the glycolysis. Next, payoff phase. Payoff phase means here we are taking 6th step to 10th step. The first 6th step is here, glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is converted into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, which is also a 3 carbon compound. The enzyme involved is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase. It is also bidirectional reaction. It requires NAD plus, 2 molecules of NAD plus. Here the third position of the carbon is phosphorylated, so it is called glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. These 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde phosphate is converted into 2 molecules of 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Here first carbon and third carbon both are phosphorylated by adding inorganic 2 molecules of inorganic phosphate, so it is called 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. This 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate again converted into 3-phosphoglycerate, which is also 3 carbon compound. We produce ATP, 2 molecules of ATP, which is used in the preparatory phase. The enzyme involving in this reaction is phosphoglycerate kinase. Here we are adding inorganic phosphates, so it is called, we are adding phosphates means the enzyme required is kinases. So this is a first substrate level of phosphorylation. Next, 3-phosphoglycerate is converted into 2-phosphoglycerate. The enzyme involved for this reaction is phosphoglyceromutase. Next, this 2 molecules of 2-phosphoglycerate is again converted into phosphoenol pyruvate, PEP, by releasing the 2 molecules of water, 2 water molecules. Means here the enzyme involved in this reaction is enolase. Enolase is inhibited by fluoride molecules. For the proper function of the enolase, we require magnesium ions or manganese ions. Phosphoenol pyruvate, which is also 3 carbon compound, which is converted into 2 molecules of pyruvate, by producing two molecules of ATP. This is the last step of the glycolysis, which is a second substrate level of phosphorylation. Here we are adding one inorganic phosphate to substrate, so it is called substrate level of phosphorylation. Here substrate is we are utilizing high energy phosphate containing substrate, so it is a substrate level of phosphorylation. We are taking this phosphate molecule which is present in substrate, that is used for the ATP production, so it is called substrate level of phosphorylation. Here is the pyruvate molecule structure. Finally we get two molecules of pyruvate, which is also a 3-carbon compound. In any type of reactions, mainly the product is inhibit the substrate activating enzymes. Here for example, in preparatory phase, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate inhibits the phosphofructokinase. Fructose 2,6, it is opposite to fructose 2,6-bisphosphate. Fructose 2,6-bisphosphate does not inactivate the or inhibit the phosphofructokinase. Only fructose 1,6-bisphosphate will inhibit the enzyme, substrate enzyme. Next the total in glycolysis, total 3 irreversible reactions are present, that is step 1, step 3 and step 10. In the middle of the reactions which are taking place in the middle of the glycolysis are bidirectional. The net gain of ATP in glycolysis is here. 2 ATP is used in the preparatory phase and 2 NADH are produced in payoff phase. Next, here 4 ATPs are produced by 2 substrate level of phosphorylation. 1 NADH in electron transport system by using electron transport system, it is converted into 2.5 ATP molecules. Here 2 NADH are produced, 2 into 2.5, that gives the 5 ATP molecules by NADH only. Next, 4 ATP are produced by substrate level of phosphorylation. Total 5 plus 4, 9 ATPs are produced in glycolysis. But here 2 ATP are utilized in the preparatory phase. So we are subtracting 2 ATP molecules from the 9 ATP. So that gives finally 7 ATP. That means net gain of ATP in glycolysis is 7 ATP. Next, here structure of adenosine triphosphate is ATP is here. Adenosine is a nucleoside which is attached with 3 phosphate molecules. Here this is the alpha phosphate, this is beta, this is gamma phosphate. To the single atom, 3PO4- minus molecules are attached, named as tri. To the adenosine, only one molecule, means here adenosine only 3 phosphates are attached. So we are using tri as a nomenclature. In fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, we are using bis as a nomenclature because here one phosphate is attached to 1st carbon and here one phosphate is attached to 6th carbon. Both are different carbons. For different molecules, any phosphates is attached means we are using as bis tris, like that. Here we are attaching 3 phosphates only to the adenosine. Means one molecule only 3 phosphates are attached. So we are nomenclature as tris. this is the difference. Next, that is only here. Here, this is fructose 1,6 bisphosphate structure is.